Hi friends, this is Rashekar Reddy. In previous video, we have downloading the GlassFish server and installing, and we also seen creating the domains, starting the domain and stopping the domain. Everything is seen in the previous video. But in this video, in order to work with web services, we need to any server is fine. But in this case, in this video, I am showing GlassFish server. In order to work with GlassFish server, we already installed. But if you want to work with through Eclipse, then you want to go to Eclipse Help, Eclipse Marketplace. Here we need to add one plugin for GlassFish. You can search here. It is taking the time. Here we need to search for GlassFish. GlassFish and search here. Here you need to install. In my case, I already downloaded that plugin. Installing that plugin is nothing but just click on install. After that, it will ask the accept agreement, license agreement. Just accept it. After that, it will take care of installing the plugin to your Eclipse. After that, it will ask restart. Click on restart. Now we are ready with the GlassFish server. First, in order to work with, we need to create one, in order to develop one provider class, first we need to have one project. For that, what I am doing is, I am trying to create one new project by using dynamic web project. I am creating new project. File new. You can search for and go to project. You can search for your dynamic web project. Dynamic web project. After that, click on next. You can give any project name. In my case, I am giving as soap demo. Soap demo is my project name. After that, I am trying directly. I am click on finish. It is asking open perspective. Just open perspective. After that, now we are ready with the project. But we need to configure the server. What I am doing is go to here. You can see in the down. You can see the servers tab. Just go there. Just select it. After that, here you can search for GlassFish. GlassFish, just click on it. After that, click on next. After that, GlassFish location, it is asking where you installed your GlassFish. On the right side, you can say search for browse. After that, in my case, I installed in F drive, some location is there. Rajshekar. After that, here, software installation, GlassFish, I am selecting. After that, click on OK. By default, it is taking the Java location also. JDK 1.8 it is taking. After that, click on next. In the next screen, we need to configure the domain where you created the domain. On the right side, you can see check here, the browse option is there. The same location, go to GlassFish. Inside GlassFish, one more folder is there, domains. Just go to domain. Here we need to specify the domain which you created earlier. In my case, my domain is already created, so that's why I'm selecting that my domain. After that, click on OK. I don't want any admin passwords or password username, anything. After that, click on next. After that, we need to add the project to the server. After that, click on select this one, add all. It is not adding. On the top, you can see cannot bridge runtime. If you are facing the same problem, we need to do one thing. First, we need to configure the server, then we need to create the project. For that, what I am doing is I am deleting the project. I am deleting the project. Delete project contents from disk. It is deleted. Now what I am trying to do is I want to configure the GlassFish server, then I will create the project. For that I will search for GlassFish. GlassFish, okay. After that click on next. We need to mention the where our GlassFish is installed. After in my case it is installed in F drive, this PC, F drive, Rajshekar, software installation, GlassFish 5, GlassFish, domains, not domains, only GlassFish is enough. Where you install that location is this way, then it will take care of everything. After that click on next. In the next screen here we need to specify the domain path where your domain is available. In my case it is available in the GlassFish. Inside one more folder is there GlassFish, select it. Inside GlassFish we have domains folder. When you expand the domains, here you can see that all the domains available in the domains folder. In my case only one domain is available, so that's why I am selecting the domain. After that click on OK. Okay, now no error is there, just click on next. No projects are there, so that's why it's not showing. After that click on finish. Now we are ready with the server. Now we will create the project. Just go to file, new, file, new, dynamic web project. You can give any project name. In my case I am giving only soap demo. Soap demo is my project name. After that select runtime. You can select GlassFish 5. When you select the GlassFish 5, by default it is taking dynamic web module version 4.0. Earlier it taken 3.0, so that's why on the top we got the error, cannot bridge, some error we got. That's the solution. So that's why we created the first, we configured the server, then we created the domain, then we created the project. Okay. After that click on next. I am not interested in anything, just click on next. I don't want any web.xml file, so that's why I am trying click on the finish button. After that it takes some time, and now the project structure is ready. Here what I want to do is I want to create a dummy JSP file, whether the I want to check whether really the project is deployed in GlassFish server or not. For that what I am doing is I am expanding this web content folder, and here I want to create one JSP file. Just select that web content, right click, new, JSP file. Here I want to give the JSP file as some index.jsp is my JSP file name. After that click on finish. It will open the JSP file in the project workspace. I'm maximizing it. I don't want this one. In the body I want to write some project is deployed. Some message I want to check whether really it is deployed in the GlassFish server or not. Project is deployed, some message I have written. What I am trying to do is first in this video I am trying to create one provider class, and I want to test it in through GlassFish server. I am closing that JSP file. Go to resources folder, SRC folder, just go there and create one class. Provider class I want to create, so that's why select that SRC folder, right click, new, class. When you are developing any provider or provider program or client program, package name should be mandatory, otherwise project will not be deployed. So that's why what I am doing is I am giving some package name. You can give any package name. In my case, it is learn to success. After that, we need to give what is the provider name we can give. In my case, I am giving operations is my provider class name. After that, click on finish. Now we are ready with the inside. I want to perform two operations. One is public int, some add. I want to perform addition, which the add method will take two parameters. One is of int a comma, another one is int b. It is taking two parameters. It is giving an error message. Just place the cursor there. Just add return statement. Here I want to return a plus b. I want one more program where I want to edit subtraction. Public int sub. It is also taking two parameters, int a comma int b. When place the cursor there, just add return statement. Here also I want to write a minus b. I want to return. Now we are ready with the provider program. Once we are ready with the provider program, on the top of the class we need to write one annotation. At web services we need to write at web services. I'm saving. After that, on the top of the, we call the methods in web services, we call that operation. We called it the methods we call as operation. The sub and addition we call as operation. One method we call as operation. The provider class name is operation. Okay, on the top of the method we need to write at web method is one annotation available. Just web method, write on the top of that method. After that, I want to write at web method. One more operation. After that, select all, control shift F to format the text. After that, I'm trying to save the program. Now what I'm doing, now we are ready with the provider class also. First we need to deploy the project. First we need to add the project to our deployment location. For that, what we need to do, just go to the servers tab. After that, select that glasses, right click, add or remove. Just click on it, just select the project, add. After that, click on finish. Now we need to start the domain, start the server, and we need to test whether it is working or not. Just select the glasses server, just right click, publish. First we need to click on publish. After that, select the domain. When you click on publish, the glasses server is trying to start. It takes some time to start the server. Once the server is started, we will get the log messages. Just observe carefully. Okay, the server is started successfully. So you can see on the servers tab, you can see the server is, glasses started and synchronized. Go to console. In order to access that our provider class, what we need to do is, here we are giving that listening at address at some URL it is giving. Copy this URL and open your browser. Any browser is fine. After that, paste this URL, just click on enter. you can check here web services is deployed. If you want, if you don't want to, we already configured that also now. If you don't know the port number, what we need to do is just to go to Eclipse. Here it is giving the port number also. In my case, the port number is some 57680 is the port number. You can check here 57680. It is whenever you stop the server, unless you started the server, the port number is every time it will keep on changing. So that's why we no need to buy out the port numbers also. When we started the server on the console, we can get all the port numbers, URLs, everything. We no need to buy out anything. Here I started the server. I just copied. You can check here the listening addresses it is giving. Just copy this URL, then you go to any browser and paste it. Just click on enter. Automatically you will get this. This screen will be get. If you don't know the port number also, what I am doing is localhost colon 57, what is the port number? 57680 57680 slash my project name is soap demo. After that I want to access my JSP page, so that's why index.jsp. Just click on it. Okay, I think enter wrong location, so that's why I got that wrong. What is the project name? Soap demo. Go to browser. You can check here. HTTP colon localhost colon 57680 slash give your project name soap demo slash give the JSP name index.jsp. When you click on enter, you can check that we are accessing the JSP file, project is deployed. If you want to test it on the console, you can check in your project. It will give the listening some address. It will give, just copy this address and paste in your browser, then click on enter. Then it will, we will get this like this screen. We will get this screen. After that, what we need to do, here it is directly giving the visual file also. Just click on that visual file. We will getting all the information. What we written by, we developed, just now we developed one provider. Okay, if you want, I will do, I will show this. This is the program we written, but the server is taking care of creating the visual file. The server is responsible to create the visual file. If you want to test this provider program, what we need to do is just change the URL question mark tester capital T tester we need to write. After that click on next. You can see here the method, two operations are available. Just for testing purpose I am giving some 10, 10, 10, 10 and 15 I am giving. After that I am trying to click on add. When I click on add, so one request will go to the server provider class and provider will process the request and it will give response in the form of SOAP request and SOAP response. The SOAP request is nothing but it is having some tags and like envelope, body, header and header and body. You can you can check by when you click on add, it will you can clearly understand. See, when you click on add, you can check that 10, 20 we entered, the output is 25. We are getting SOAP request. SOAP requested is in the form of like this. The root tag is here envelope. You can check here envelope is the root tag. Inside envelope we have the header tag. Inside header, inside after header we got one body is there. In the body it is taking two parameters 10 and 15. This is the SOAP request format. When we click on that 10, 20 and we click on add, server is taking care of creating this SOAP request format. And the when we click on that server request, go to the provider class. Provider will process the request, and the response will be in the form of same the SOAP response only. So that's why server only taking care of sending the response in the form of SOAP response. So that's why you got the output as 25. In the SOAP response, you can check that return 25. This is the output we got. Okay. If you want to similarly test that, one more method is there, no sub method, you can check that also. If I want to test 50, I want to give another number as 10, when you click on sub, 50, 60 it is taking, it is giving the output as 40, SOAP request, SOAP response. Like this, we can test our web services program. If you want to know more about the visitor file, just click on visitor file. It will give the all the visitor file information. Visitor file information. This is the provider class code in order to work with. If you don't know the location where we need to access that our visitor file, just copy this one. In the console, you can find it, listening at address at, it will give the URL, just copy this URL, go to any browser, just paste it, just click on next, click on enter, it will give address and the visitor file location, visitor file also. When you click on visitor, it will give the everything. If you want to test it, there are so many tools are available for testing visitor file. One is SOAP UI. Like, or you can test here itself by just remove that visitor and write tester, click on enter. By using this screen also you can test, or otherwise you can test by using SOAP UI, or so many other tools are available. In upcoming videos you will see all the tools. In the next video we will see the same program with WebLogic server also. Thank you friends, thank you for watching. If you not subscribed my channel, just subscribe to my channel.